So our next task is to review and edit the construction materials. We will go to the Constructions tab on the left. You will see at the top there are several sub-tabs to the Constructions tab: Construction Sets, Constructions, and Materials. Each of these is treated as a child-parent relationship. Construction Sets is a group of construction assemblies that will be applied to the building. You can see that in this construction set, fire station metal, we have exterior surface constructions. For the walls, exterior walls, we have metal building, concrete slab, and metal building roof. Interior surface constructions consist of an interior wall, interior floor, and interior ceilings. Ground contact surfaces are, for this instance, all concrete. Exterior subsurface constructions consist of windows and doors and skylights. In addition, there are interior subsurface constructions. For example, if you have interior partitions with windows or doors. And then at the very bottom, there are other constructions that may be applied. So a construction set defines a collection of constructions that make up the building and can be applied to the building or portions of the building. Next, let's look at the Constructions tab. The Constructions tab shows construction assemblies. We will look at the first one, metal building roof. The metal building roof is comprised of metal roofing and roof insulation. You'll see that these materials are applied in layers because they will be used to calculate the thermal conductivity and heat transfer properties of this construction assembly. The layer starts on the outside, metal roofing, and moves inward, roof insulation, inside the building. You will notice that there are measure tags. Similarly, how we discussed, these measure tags are located throughout the project. These are for advanced energy modeling. Basically, you can apply measure tags to anything within OpenStudio. And at the very end, you can use those measure tags as keywords that energy efficiency measures can be applied to and automatically calculate how a building might be different if various variables are changed. But that is for advanced energy modeling. We will discuss that later. First, let's look at this metal roofing, this metal roof. The metal roof is comprised of metal roofing and roof insulation 22. In order to find out what this roof insulation 22 is, we need to go to the Materials tab. Select Materials on the left, drop down, roof insulation 22. You can see that this roof insulation material also has measure tags, and it has thermal properties: roughness, how thick it is, thermal conductivity, density, specific heat, and thermal, solar, and visible absorptance. You can see that the thermal conductivity and thickness combined together for this particular roof insulation is approximately an R27 insulative value. Let's take a look at our project. Our roof is composed of metal roofing, a thermal break spacer, and steel purlins plus insulation. So let's edit this roof assembly. What we'll do is we're not going to be using this roof insulation for any other assembly. So we'll just rename this purlins and insulation R29. You'll notice that the purlins plus insulation is approximately 10 inches thick, and it has an R value of 29.88, which is a 0.0028 thermal conductivity. So let's change this. 10 inches thick, 0.0028 thermal conductivity. Now we have edited that construction material. But next, we also have to create that thermal break. Let's duplicate this construction material. Select times 2. And we will call this thermal break R3. Looking at the thermal break, we have an R value of 3, which basically equates to a half inch thickness and 0.1167 thermal conductivity. Now that we've created those two materials, let's go back to the construction assembly for the metal roof. Select the Constructions tab. You'll notice that we start with metal roofing, but then it goes directly to the purlins and insulation that we just edited. But we need to put this thermal break in between. So first, let's delete this. Click the X. Next, go to My Model, Materials, and find our thermal break. Drag it from our My Model library and drop it into the construction assembly. You may have to click another assembly to refresh. Click Roof Metal Building again. You can see that it has been put in place. Next, select the purlins and insulation layer. Now you can see that our metal building roof has been edited to include metal roofing, a thermal break, and purlins and insulation with an R29 value. That is how you edit materials and material assemblies. Let's rename this to simply Roof Metal Building. You can see that if you go to the Construction Sets tab, it will automatically be updated because we just edited that file. Roof Metal Building. Also, if you do not want to go through the process of creating your own materials and assemblies, you can look in the library files to search for a construction set that suits your needs. The process is as simple as dragging and dropping in place. You would go to Constructions and search for a roof. We'll just use this as an example. R31, R25. We'll just use this as an example. Drag it and drop it into place. Now, our construction set uses this roof instead of the roof we just created. But we won't use this. Go back to my model. Select constructions. Drag roof metal building into place. Similarly, you can do that for windows, doors, walls, and floors. If you do not have material you're looking for in your local libraries, you can search the building component library. Go up to the top, drop down components and measures, and select find components. If you do not have the building component library located on your computer, you will need to register online. Once you have registered online, the Building Component Library will provide you with an authorization code, and copy the authorization code, paste it into your BCL auth key, and click OK. This will give you access to the Building Component Library online. It will take you to a new screen that allows you to search online the Building Component Library. Let's say we wanted a window on the Building Component Library that we don't have in our local library files. Click the drop-down on Construction Assemblies, Fenestration, Windows. You can go through and search the library online for the metal window for the windows that you're looking for. Let's just select this one. Window metal framing all other complies with 189.1/2009 residential 2A climate zone. Click the check button and click download. When it's done downloading, you can close this window. Next, go to your library tab, select Constructions drop down, and search for the file that you downloaded. right here. We can use this and drop this into any one of the window categories. We'll just use it for fixed windows for this project. There. And you can see that this is a building component library component because it's denoted with a BCL. So that is constructions, construction sets, and materials.